Hey, Scale guys, Nexas here. Welcome back to Destiny 2. And in today's video, we're back with more weapons to review. And with the obviously Friday reset and everything, we have gotten Trials of Osiris back into the game. And guys, I will say, I solo queued. It's not bad anymore. Honestly, Trials is very accessible for everybody. Even if you want to go in and just try win some rounds to get gear, it is totally worth it now. There's barely any I don't think I ran into any cheaters yesterday. I played it for a bit, but it is so glorious right now. I will suggest anyone who is afraid of Trials and never really want to do it, just go into solo queue. Queue up a little bit, get some wins in, get some rounds done, get some gear. And what we're going to be looking at today is going to be one of the newest weapons to the Trials of Osiris, which is going to be Reed's Regret. Now, I don't usually do linear fusion rifles reviews and everything like that, but this one is going to be really sweet. This weapon is a stasis linear fusion rifle, first of all, the only one of its kind, and also that it's going to be one of the only ones with the little known perk called, where is it? Triple tap. See, with this weapon, we all know that linear fusion rifles right now, with the artifact, obviously, with the particle deconstruction, it is just, they're wrecking. Linear fusion rifles are insane right now. And DPS-wise, this is going to be a DPS king because it will come with triple tap and vorpal weapons. So if you think about it, you can get a vorpal with triple tap, which is just insane DPS phases. You just keep on shooting. You can get triple tap firing line, which I actually kind of have, which I have in this one. I've got clown cartridge firing line. So clown cartridge, honestly, this is kind of similar to triple tap because triple tap, well, you can get maxes an extra 2 bullets. Well, clown cartridge can actually refill it with an extra 2 bullets as well, just for reloading. So technically, the god rolls you're going to be looking for is going to be clown cartridge or triple tap in this slot. And then this other trait in the daddy trait, we're going to be looking for either firing line or vorpal. Now, the reason people are saying not firing line right now is because it's actually bugged. But once firing line becomes a thing, it's going to be freaking nuts. When it comes to GMs, any sorts of PvE events, you're going to want to have the best DPS. And this is going to be DPS king. And not for nothing, guys. This thing looks hella freaking sick. I mean, look at this golden beaut. But yeah, as I said, I don't generally do linear fusion rifle reviews. I'm not going to be going into the stats and numbers, boys. We're just going to go into some... We'll try PvP maybe first and a bit of PvE as well. We'll just showcase just what it's like and everything damage-wise if it can wreck with the particle deconstruction as well. It should slay in PvE and everything. So without further ado, let's go into some PvP with the Reed's Regret. Alrighty, so we're going to be on a Widow's Short. So yeah, this is actually going to be a good map for it. But we're going to try, obviously... wait for heavy and everything. So this got me real quick. Well, as I said, that this this fusion linear, it should be actually really sweet anyway, PvP, because linears obviously have a ton of aim assist and everything. And if we can hit dome skis, ooh, it's sweet. Guys, don't flip the spawns, please. Boys, please. Please. Oh, no, they're going to do it on me. Oh, no, they've done it to me. You guys, you just done screwed me. You just done screwed me. Oh, my God. All right, come on. Come on. Come on, baby. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Oh, up. Oh, I hit a body shot. Oh, there's the kill fight. So yeah, you will see that the damage is going to be pretty sweet and everything on it. We'll get a headshot of this guy. No, we the freaking flinch with an ace. Oh my God. Yeah, it is going to have flinch and everything. But you can see damage is going to be two-shot body and everything. The only thing people will say is like, why would you bother using these heavies in PvP when you could literally use just like, I could use a Lorenz driver or something like that or an Arbalest. And that makes sense. And this guy better leave me the hell alone. With his goddamn ace of spades. Alrighty, so it's taking me a hot minute to get another bit of freaking heavy ammo, but we're going in with it again. As I said, I knew the PvP wouldn't be that easy to get heavy or whatever, so as I said, it would just be real short of me just getting ammo for it. But I will admit that, yeah, when it comes to it, that people will be like, there's just no point to them in PvP right now. And I do admit that. I don't understand what Bungie... kind of see what these are like in PvP. I mean, should they all move to the secondary? I don't know, because DPS-wise, PvP or PvE, it would kind of screw them over. But, like, you can see that they can do damage, and that's a rampage roll, and I can't even one-shot that dude. What? So, yeah, that is... oh, my God. No, no, no. Oh, and he dip. But that's, like, rampage on it as well. Still doesn't one-shot. But you can't hit domes. I mean, it will hit the headshot. There's a double kill. So I'm not saying that they're bad or anything, PvP. They will do damage, but realistically, right, like even there, charge time, I do that with a freaking Lorenz, I'd say, if I really needed to, or an RB. Okay, I got a bit more, boys. We got a bit more. We can actually dome some dude. Okay, this guy's going to run at me with a heavy or something. I don't know, but we'll dome him. Man, I would love to see what this would be like with the L freaking, what's it called? Headstone. Just like, see a popsicle pop when you absolutely dome someone out of it. Now, oh, that's a guy with thing, but there's the headshot. I mean, I said, they are good fusions, and charge time is good and everything. It's just that if I hit a body shot when I'm using heavy, I'm gonna, like that. I would be pissed if I didn't get the kill, and this guy Somehow I couldn't hit him, but that's what I mean. You hit one body shot with a heavy weapon? Come on. I want to hit it. If these go one shot body, honestly, I think they'd be so much better in terms of PvP and everything. I know people might think they're a bit OP, but if I use a freaking Whisper, I can body shot one shot with them. Well, this is probably going to be the W anyway. We're kind of beating these, but I will say that even if you look at heavy-wise, it's definitely, I would say it's bad PvP, but it's definitely, definitely very situational. I'm going to try to help him out, but it's definitely situational compared to other weapons you can use. Alrighty, so we're going to do some, obviously, PvE stuff, and what better way to do it than going into the new seasonal event, and what, my screen just went freaking wild there. But yeah, this PvE is where the reads we're getting is going to be better. I know it's kind of weird to kind of go, oh, Charles' weapon we're farming is for PvE? Yeah, that's it. That's what we're doing nowadays. But this is going to be it in PvE. You'll see that PvE, it's going to annihilate. Now, this is my firing line and clamp cartridge roll. So when I do get the clamp cartridge going, you'll see you get 6 bullets in the mag, which only is extra 1, which obviously triple tap will give you 2. But clamp cartridge for me, honestly, is just as good as triple tap. You can get 8 in the mag, you can get 7, 6. So realistically, it's going to be somewhat similar to triple tap, but you don't have to hit headshots with it. You can miss a shot or whatever and still have it going. So it's one of the most annoying things ever when you miss. Now, baby, someone gave us a rally barricade. But yeah, PvE, this is going to be where it's sweet. You can see firing line is going to proc constantly. Now, I know firing line is bugged right now, boys. I know people are going to be, yeah, but firing line is bugged right now. She needs vorpal. Vorpal, yes, it is nice. And obviously, because it's not bugged, it's obviously going to be better. It makes sense. But when it comes down to it, firing line, honestly, is going to be the overall, the better perk to go for. Because it's going to do... Oh, I just punched the scream. That's not what you want to do. But overall, that's what it comes down to it. Firing line gives you 20% buff, whereas the L Vorpal weapon only gives you 15. So you're getting an extra 5%, which if you don't bats, boys, that's better. But there's the 8 in the magazine with the clan cartridge. You got the firing line going as well. As I said, you can get so much stuff going with it. I just whiffed that shot. But you can easily get a proc'd and everything like that as well with terms of damage and everything. So realistically, clamp cartridge firing line or triple tap firing line, it's gonna be the best setup you can go for. Now there's guys up here, boys, keep grouped up. I need a firing line this dude. He's up there. Oh, look at that, just absolutely freaking wrecked. So yeah, honestly, at the moment, I will say that everybody's farming the freaking wrong one. Everyone's farming the wrong god roll. It's gonna be firing line. I know the Vorpal obviously is the god roll right now just because of how the weapon is and everything, or how all the perks obviously working and stuff like that. But do not sleep on the L firing line, honestly. Once you get it going, it will start to do damage, but you gotta get it going, and there's no one here. But there's the damage anyway, with the freaking particle deconstructor as well this season. Yeah, this thing is just a DPS machine. I know Treaded Needle was one, but this is honestly more farmable than Treaded Needle. You can actually focus farm this, unlike the Treaded Needle, where you had to get freaking RNG. Big mofos over here, though, and there's the damage, and look at it go increase. We have the fire line going, 54% stacking, boys, we stacking, and there's the clam cartridge going in, and then I got 8 in the mag again, so the freaking clam cartridge, I'm telling you, with this, with obviously rally barricades or whatever, it will just absolutely freaking annihilate people. I mean, double shot that ogre, it's just so good DPS-wise. And that's what I'm saying. People are going to look at this and think that, oh, clan cartridge, maybe not triple tap either. Because triple tap is only on this freaking linear as well. So Treaded Needle can't get triple tap or anything. But even so, I will still say that clan cartridge is no slouch. It can still do as much work for you. So it's a mix. If you get a Vorpal, but you have clan cartridge instead, don't sleep on it, guys. It's still going to wreck ass. All right, boys, focus up. Do the DPS. DPS, DPS, DPS. Get up, get up, get up. Man, the damage when everyone just starts firing at it with the freaking Vorpals, or not the Vorpals, the freaking thing. 8 bullets in the mag, though, with the particle deconstructor. Once everybody starts popping it, the damage increase is just freaking nuts. Oh, guys, can we get rid of this freaking ogre? He's just in our face. Thank you. We'll get rid of this one as well. We'll get this reload. Oh, we can't actually. Can't reload yet. Do I waste the bullet to reload? Now, max I'll get is 7, but I'll probably get it. There we go. 7 in the mag again. It's just straight up. You don't even need to have triple head precisions or whatever. Just hit those. What? Take a shield off, boys. How do you get a shield back? But just, you don't even have to hit precisions. You just have to fire, and you get, obviously, you just get your max DPS in. So, as I said, if you have the Roddy Barricades, Luna Factions, whatever you've got going for quick reloads, it's going to be sweet. And this is the normal version as well, guys. This isn't even the adept version, because obviously, because it is a Trials weapon, there will be an adept version of this weapon too. So with that adept version, you could get the charge, the extra charge time. We can get the extra, oh, these guys back. But we can get the charge time going. We can get the extra big ones going. So you get big ones for extra DPS against bosses. So right now, this is already DPS king, but it's not even in its final freaking form. I mean, this is going to be freaking sweet once the adept version comes out. Well, that is it for me and the Reed's Regret. But honestly, it should, instead of saying Reed's Regret, it should just say DPS king. Because honestly, this is one of the best DPS guns in the game right now. It is actually the best. Legendaries are actually outperforming the exotics just because of charge time and everything. But definitely speaking, this Reed's, it just slays with the, obviously this particle deconstructor mod for our deconstruction. It's just gonna absolutely annihilate people. It's just how the mods work each season. It's that this one archetype's gonna do really well, but it's actually kind of fun to get linears doing well. I know I'm saying Vorpal is not the god role, but it is for solo players, okay? If you're a solo player, Vorpal is your god role. But if you're thinking of raid or GMs, raids, whatever, this is gonna be the god role for it. Triple tap or clan characters, as I said, they're kind of the same. Triple tap is a bit more consistent where clan cartridge isn't, but clan cartridge gives you that you don't even have to hit headshots to have the extra bullets in your mic, whereas the triple tap does. So it is just personal preference, but overall, firing line is what you should be looking for, guys, if you're going for raid DPS machines. Do not think that Vorpal is the only one or is the best one, because firing line, once it's bugged, will be better. Vorpal right now is better just because firing line is broken, but overall, it's 100% worth getting a roll of this at all, firing line or Vorpal, because right now Reed's Regret is just slaying PvE. At PvP, it wasn't bad either. I know it's kind of memey to go in with linear fusion rifle, but it can do well. But I will still say, yeah, it's probably not. Linear fusion rifles just aren't PvP weapons, really. In the heavy slot, obviously energy ones like Arbalest, Lorenz is good. Now, how you get the Reed's Regret as well, if you've never unlocked it before and you want to focus toward it, you've got to get the Trials Engrams and hope you get a drop. It is kind of RNG. You got to hope to get a drop from the Cryptarch. Go to the Cryptarch with a Trials Engram. Hopefully, when you submit it, he will give you a drop of this. You could get anything, though. But once you get this, then you can start to use those Trials Engrams at Saint 14 to target farm the Reed's Regret. That's how you get your good rolls. But honestly, I will say, Reed's Regret, 100% get this while you can, get it this week, because it could become where firing line, this could get buffed next week or whatever, and if it's not Friday, you won't be able to get a roll of it. But regardless, if you like the video, show us a like, and you want to see more content, subscribe and press today, and hopefully I'll see you the next collective in the next one.